Hello. Today we are going to make a letter of Russian alphabet, letter D. Inflate a balloon leaving about 5-inch flat tail. Twist the first about 1-inch bubble. Twist the second soft about 1-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the second bubble in one lock twist. Twist the third about 1-inch bubble. Twist the fourth soft about 1-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the fourth bubble in one lock twist. We have made the left bottom corner of the letter D. Twist the fifth about 4-inch bubble. Twist the sixth soft 1-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the sixth bubble in one lock twist. Twist the seventh about 2-inch bubble. Twist the eighth soft 1-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the 8th bubble in one lock twist. Twist the 9th about 4-inch bubble. Twist the 10th soft about 1-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the 10th bubble in one lock twist. Twist the 11th about 1-inch bubble. Twist the 12th soft about 1-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the 12th bubble in one lock twist. I'm fixing bubbles in proper positions. This way it is easier to see what we have to do next. So now we have to twist the 13th about 1-inch bubble and cut off the rest of the balloon tie of the ends. But first let's twist the 14th soft about 1-inch bubble, lock both ends of the 14th bubble in one lock twist. Twist the 15th 1-inch bubble, it's gonna be the pop-up bubble. Twist the 16th 1-inch bubble, lock both ends of the 16th bubble in one lock twist. Now let's use the scissors to pop the 15th bubble. Here comes very loud boom! We successfully separated balloon on two parts. Let's put the rest of the balloon aside for now. We have to deflate the 14th bubble. It is probably the most difficult part. Now let's tie off the end of the balloon. As you can see in this example, the left and the right side of our sculpture look the same. Now we're going to use the second part of our balloon that we cut off previously to make kind of a bridge between the fourth and tenth bubbles. Here's the second part of our balloon. It's quite long. So I'm going to deflate it, make it shorter. Basically, we need up to 3-inch long bubble to make the bridge. Let's tie off the end of the balloon and lock this end with the fourth bubble of our sculpture. Bring both sides of letter D in proper positions to measure the size of bubble we have to twist. Twist the bubble. It should be slightly longer than the seventh bubble on top of the letter there. Lock the free end of this bubble with the tenth bubble of our sculpture. Cut off the rest of the balloon. You can do it with scissors or use your fingers. Tie off the end, hide it between bubbles of the sculpture. Fix all bubbles in proper positions. Congratulations! We have made the letter D. Here's the side view, the back view, and the front view the same. Usually I attach letters to each other with sewing threads. I use sewing threads of the same or similar color as the background color. This way sewing threads become almost invisible even from close distance. As you can see, I simply loop the sewing thread around small bubbles of the sculpture. I tie the letter at each corner, so there are four points, and now I can suspend the letter in air or attach it to the wall using clear sticky tape, for example. Okay, congratulations again, we have made the letter D. Have fun and happy twisting!